And when you arrive, anoint Azariah as king over Syria. Also, you shall anoint Jehu, the son of Nimshi, as king over Israel. And Elisha, the son of Shaphat, of Abel Mahola, you shall anoint as prophet in your place. Verse 17. It shall be that whoever escaped the sword of Hazael, Jehu will kill. And whoever escaped the sword of Jehu, Elisha will kill. Yet I have reserved 7,000 in Israel whose knees have not bowed to Baal, and every tongue or mouth has not kissed him. So he departed from there and found Elisha, the son of Shaphat, who was plowing with 12 yoke of oxen before him, and he was with the 12. Then Elijah passed by him and threw his mantle on him, and he left the oxen and ran after Elijah and said, "Please let me kiss my father and my mother, and then I will follow you." And he said to him, "Go back, for what have I done to you?" So Elisha turned back from him and took a yoke of oxen and slaughtered them and boiled their flesh, using the oxen's equipment, and gave it to the people and the earth. Then he rose and followed Elijah and became his servant. Somebody say amen.
Amen. Amen.
The second scripture is 2 Kings chapter 2 from verse 9. And so it was, when they had crossed over, that Elijah said to Elisha, "Ask, what may I do for you before I am taken away from you?" Elisha said, "Please, let a double portion of your spirit be upon me." So he said, "You have asked a hard thing. Nevertheless, if you see me when I'm taken from you, it shall be so for you. But if not, it shall not be so." Then it happened, as they continued on and talked, that suddenly a chariot of fire appeared with horses of fire and separated the two of them. And Elijah went up by a whirlwind into heaven. Verse 12, and Elijah saw it. Amen. Somebody say, "I will see it."
I will see it.
Somebody say, "I will see it."
I will see it.
Some of you, like Doc is saying, you must see. There is something about a transfer. He said, if you see it, you will receive it. Amen. But if you don't see it, you'll be left behind. Somebody say, "I will see it."
I will see it.
And Elisha saw it, and he cried, "My father, my father, the chariot of Israel and his horsemen." So he saw him no more, and he took hold of his own clothes and tore them into two pieces. Into how many pieces?
Two.
And he took upon the mantle of Elijah that had fallen from him, and went back and stood by the bank of the Jordan. Amen.
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 Amen. Amen.
There are two impartations here. The man of God, Elijah, which means my God is Jehovah. My God is Yahweh. My God is the Lord. That was the name the father gave to him. The father gave that name when idol worshiping or Baal worshiping was taking dominion of the nation. And nobody knew the father, but the name the father gave indicates that their father knew Jehovah God. How can you give a godly name to your child where everybody around you is worshiping Baal? So although we don't know the name of the father or we don't know who they are, the Bible was silent about who they are. Elijah only appeared. So nobody knows about the background. But the name he carries shows that this guy had godly parents who trust in Jehovah.
Amen.
That everything can crash, but our God, who is above all, shall stand. So while they were worshiping idol, while they were worshiping Baal, he looked upon the face of all their worshiping and said, I refuse to worship Baal, but I will name my child, my God is God.
Amen.
Elijah, I pray God will be God.
Amen.
Let every man be a liar. And our God be true.
Amen.
And then he just appeared. I pray you will appear suddenly.
Amen.
No satellite will be upon you.
Amen.
Nobody is checking your background. Nobody knows where you are coming from. Because of my father anointing, you just appear.
Amen.
May you receive your
blessing. Receive it.
One day, one minister of our church called me from north part of Africa, north part of America, and he said, Pastor, by then I was Pastor Irian, but as for you, how did it happen? Because he was my pensa leader. And some of them thought I was unserious in life because of my haircut, because of the way I dance, because of the way I live my life. They didn't know I was spiritual. And now I become an area head and he said, Christian pastor somewhere. So he called me one day and said, you see, your life made me surprised because I don't know how did it happen. Because, I mean, I was the leader and you were not even executive member. And all they said, well, you don't know. I just appeared.
Amen.
I pray that anointing will get about you.
Amen.
And you just appear. Receive your miracle. Receive your miracle. Many people are thinking that you'll be on the line. You'll be an deacon, an elder, professional overseer, an underseer, and whatever. But God will break protocol.
Amen.
For your sake, God will break protocol.
Amen.
You will just appear.
Amen.
Like your star will appear.
Amen.
Your star will appear.
Amen.
I pray that my father,
Amen.
Will bring you to the prominency.
Amen.
Receive the invitation of your miracle of appearance in the name of Jesus. So the guy just appeared. And when he appeared, he confronted idol worshiping. He looked, God didn't tell him that. But James taught us or teaches us that Elijah was a man like you and I. And Amplified Bible will tell you he has a passion, constitution, like you and I. He works like you and I. But he spoke. I pray that your word, God will honor the word of his servant.
Amen.
And perform the counsel of his messenger. He spoke that as the Lord lives, there shall not be rain or dew except at my word. May God give you the power to unlock and to lock.
Amen.
May you have the power.
Amen.
Oh, Jesus said,
Amen.
I give to you the keys.
Receive it.
That whatsoever you bind on earth shall be bound in heaven.
Amen.
And whatsoever you lose on earth
Amen.
Shall be loosed in heaven.
Amen.
May you have the keys to padlock every act and every opposition. And say, I padlock your mouth.
Yes.
I padlock your life. And you have the power to hold the key. Put it in your pocket. Walk upon this earth until you come to a time and say, now I have the power to unlock. May you receive. My father, my father. And said, there shall not be dew or rain, except at my word. And he placed a key into his pocket. And if you spoke in the word of God, and you spoke the word of God, God will provide for you.
Amen.
Let every one in the system be against you. Let God be for you.
Amen.
I said in the Rahab conference that thousand or minority with God is greater than majority without God.
Amen.
So he placed a key in his pocket. For 3 solid years, there was no dew, nor rain. And Ahab searched for him, sent to every country, every kingdom, and asked the kings to swear. Have you seen Elijah? But I want you to know that if you are speaking for God, he hides you. Mm. He that dwells in the secret place of the Most High shall abide under the shadow. Oh, can I preach it? Of the Almighty,
yes.
I will say of the Lord, it's my refuge, my fortress, my God, in whom I trust. The Lord is my shield and my fortress. He's my hiding place. Can I preach it now?
Yes.
The Lord is my hiding place. I am under the rock. The rock is higher than I. Jehovah hides me under the rock. God tell my enemy. Am I preaching? I am under the rock. Jehovah hides me under the rock. That's what the song says. Under the rock. God was hiding the man of God. And it got to a time that man of God, God said, go and appear before the man that you are hiding from. Go and appear, present yourself to Ahab. And he met Obadiah and said, go and tell your master, Elijah is here. The anointing of God is here.
Amen.
Amen.
Don't be afraid of the terror by day.
No. The pestilence by night.
Or the pestilence by night.
Jesus.
Elijah is here. Yes. The anointing of God is here.
Amen.
And then we all know the story of Mount Carmel encounter. While they try to bring fire from heaven, cut themselves. And Elijah was saying, maybe your God is asleep. Maybe he's gone on a trip. Just call him the more. You see, you don't need hard voice to bring God's anointing.
No.
If God is on your side, the little push, he will bring fire.
Amen.
I pray that the fire will come upon your life.
Amen.
The Holy Ghost fire will come upon your life.
Jesus.
And when the Bible says, when it came to the time of prayer, and this is the time of prayer, Elijah came and gathered the stones, the broken stones, the 12 tribes of Israel, the covenant. He said, bring it together and then put water. You see, God will do something that contradicts laws, signs, and everything. Jesus operates against law of flotation by walking on water. He operates against law of gravity by just entering into the skies and no gravitational force will pull him down. He operates over economy, law of economy, scarcity and choice. Whilst he can take some few loaves of bread and fish and multiply it, and you realize that Jesus is Jesus by himself. He's God by himself. He operates under the law of nature. If somebody dies, the person cannot come back again. But Jesus can call the dead. Lazarus, come forth. And I'm praying in the name of Jesus. This anointing is more.